But how does colorblindness come from cones?
So actually, before we talk about colorblindness, I think it makes sense to talk a little bit about color.
I think that's a great idea, because what exactly is color?
So remember how we talked about how sound is a wave?
Yeah.
Light's actually a wave too.
Oh, really?
And so what that means is that, well, remember the properties of waves. Do you remember which property corresponded to pitch?
Yeah, that was frequency.
Exactly. And so what would a, for example, high frequency wave look like?
It would look like this.
And what about a low frequency wave?
It would look like this.
Excellent, that's perfect. So high frequency, lots of fast oscillations, low frequency, fewer waves per second, slower oscillations.
So what does frequency have to do with light waves?
Well, Lauren, with light, we actually usually talk about wavelength, which is the distance between, let's say, here and here. And light waves can have all sorts of wavelengths, but we can only see certain wavelengths.
Which wavelengths can we see?
The smallest we can see is 400 nanometers, and the largest is about 750.
But what's a nanometer?
Ah, right. Well, one nanometer is actually equal to 1/1,000,000,000th of a meter.
Well, what's the difference between the big ones and the small ones?
Well, that's how we see color. Let me show you something.